I'm going to get out of the way for the main event, which is our Kid Life presenting a wonderful Christmas program for you this morning.
On the outskirts of Bethlehem, angels had gathered in the night sky for a brilliant announcement like none other.
Jesus has come to earth as a baby, and the angels were so excited to let the world know about it.
Luke 2 tells us, "And suddenly there was a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, 'Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men.'"
Even though his arrival was over 2,000 years ago, it was a night mankind would never forget.
What did Jesus mean to the angels? His coming meant good news of great joy for all the people.
Thank you.
hillside outside Bethlehem, the angels' glorious message of Christ's birth was to a group of lowly shepherds tending their flocks at night.
When the angels had left them and gone to heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord told us about."
So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger.
When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed about what the shepherds said to them.
What did Jesus mean to the shepherds? He meant hope for all mankind, that he would come to earth and humble himself, being like them.
After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him."
Following the star in the sky, these wise men set out on a long, long journey.
The star they had seen when it rose went ahead of them and them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed.
On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
What did Jesus mean to the wise men? He was a gift more precious than any gift they could ever give him.
Sing me now a Christmas.
some, Christmas can mean sparkling lights on a tree filled with lots of decorations.
For others, Christmas can mean ripping into the red and green packages, shimmering with ribbons and bows.
And to some, Christmas can mean dashing here and there from one store to another, trying to pick out the perfect gift.
Yet, without Jesus, there's no angel announcement, no shepherds on the hillside, no manger filled with hay, and no gifts from the wise men.
What does Jesus mean to me? For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life.
Jesus means Christmas to me.
Thank you.
good news for all people.
To the shepherds, Jesus was a humble child in the manger, set for mankind.
To the wise men, Jesus was the King of the Jews.
What does Jesus mean to you and me today?
As was told by the prophet Isaiah, "For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called
Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace."
Apparently, one of the animals is following me up on stage now. Wasn't that wonderful? That is one of my favorite things, to have the story of the child told by children. So I'm so glad you're able to join us this morning. So thank you so much, kids. Thank you for Kelsey and her team and all the volunteers. Thank you, parents, for bringing them here week after week and on the weekends to practice to prepare for this moment. And I don't know if you saw this, but it was incredibly accurate. Did you see how unruly the animals were? Exactly like it was that first Christmas. And so that's the kind of level of realism you get here at New Life. So we're so glad that you joined us. Well, we're going to kind of bless this time and just really lift up our prayers to God, because we know that not only was Jesus born, but he lived the perfect life and died on the cross, and he reigns on high. And he truly cares about every need and every concern we have. And so we're going to lift up our concerns and our needs and our prayers to God right now. So please join me in prayer.